This is Theme Park for the Atari Jaguar, a simulation-based game. It came out in the early 90s, and at a time it came out with a whole ton of different systems. And you start off by making a theme park, and right here you choose what settings you want, and you pick where you're going to go. Let's say you want to go to England, and you say, okay. And I set the settings up to give a helper on this particular one so that it'll tell you what to do. So as you go through each of the screens at the bottom down there, we'll have a little guy that says do this or do that. And he's helping you out. After you figure out how to play the game, you shut it off and it's not bothering you anymore. So I bought a piece of land in England and I'm going to set up a theme park. And so here I am, I'm going to set up a castle. So you have so much money and you pay for different things. I paid for the land, and here I go, I'm getting a certain ride. This is a castle ride. And you also need characters at the park for the kids to see. Here's a shark man dude. And without the characters, then the kids have no one to play with. The more fun the place is, the more kids are going to come and play. You also have different types of trees and scenery that you can make the place look a lot nicer. You can create walls for people to walk around. You can create paths for them to go around. You can create a whole bunch of different things. Here is a path, which is a sidewalk that the people will walk on. If you don't have a sidewalk, they're just walking around randomly around the park. What you want to do is you want to get the kids in, you want them to get them to the rides, and you want to get them off the rides and keep them on the path so that they're doing this as much as possible so they're more happy. You also have flowers you can plant, signs you can put up, and all of these different things. Here you can have the box office for the particular ride. A waiting line, so there are more people that can stand in line and wait at a time. You can have it going at the very beginning and also at the end of the ride, just like a regular theme park. So the longer the wait, the less likely the kids are going to want to come back. They're less experienced. So as you play the game, you add more rides, you buy more rides, and you add more things to do. They have a bus. Notice how it's a short bus, so these aren't the smartest kids in the world. They bring the kids off to the park, and other kids leave it. And they leave. These kids got little hamburgers on their heads, which means they're thinking about food. There's no food. On the left of the screen, you have a big ice cream right there. So I set up an ice cream thing. So you can have all these different things you can build and so forth. And it's just a simulation game. It's pretty fun. I give this game a B. It doesn't look that snazzy. It looks just like a lack of music in it, so it's kind of boring to play. It's okay to play on a Jaguar controller versus a mouse, but if it looked a little snazzier, it'd probably get a higher rating. I give it a B.